question is, student, the topic for discussion today is placenta. So as you know, placenta is a disc-like, it is a disc-like connection, between what? Between the fetus and the mother, or the embryo and the mother, between the fetus and the mother. So that is placenta. It is derived from the word which means cake. So it is a cake like structure. It's a spongy in nature. It has a blood circulation. Everything is there. So it is a disc like structure which forms the connection between the maternal and fetal tissue, and thus it helps in the transfer of material. Like we see what are the various functions of placenta. So what is the, we can see what are the various functions. So functions of placenta. Okay. So what are the various functions? So main, the connection between mother and fetus is for what? Is for nourishment, for nutrition. Nutrition. So everything the mother will eat will go to the fetus, and it help in the fetal development. So this provides the nutrition, then exchange of oxygen, nutrients, everything is via this placenta. Then what will happen? It secretes many hormones also. Hormones which help in the maintenance of the pregnancy, even like progesterone, which help in the maintenance of your pregnancy. Okay, pregnancy or the maintenance of the pregnancy. So placental tissue, and what will it happen? So most important in this COVID time, what is you require is immunity. So it provide, it helps in the transfer of, helps in the transfer of immunoglobulins also, or what, IgM, IgG antibodies, and what, via this it will provide immunity to the fetus. So these are the important function of the placenta which you must have learned. Or you will be learning this in physiology also. But basically here we are dealing with the anatomy of the placenta. So we will see how it is derived, what are the basic structure of placenta, all these things in detail here. So it is a disc-like connection, as we all know, it's a shaped like cake. So from which tissue it will be derived? Okay, so we have read about two type of tissue. So we, this blastocyst, this is the blastocyst. We start from a scratch. So this is inner cell mass. Okay, the blue one. And in this, this is the outer cell mass. Or the trophoblast. So how do you remember? So trophy. Trophy कहाँ मिलता है? It's not in home, it's in outside. So we get from outside, like in market and all those things. So we will remember that trophoblast develop from the outer cell mass, and which ultimately will give rise to placenta. To our placenta, which form the connection, where the inner cell mass, we all know this is the inner cell mass which will give rise to your embryo or your embryoblast. Okay, so how this is going to form? So this blastocyst is going to follow what process? We all have read, it will get implanted, it will form. The process will be the implantation. So it will be implanted or it will be embedded. Like in humans, we know there is a rich type of, there will be interstitial type of implantation. So whole of this blastocyst, whole of blastocyst is embedded in endometrium. So पूरा का पूरा blastocyst जो है embedded हो जाता है कहाँ? Endometrium में. So endometrium of the mother. So it is not merely attached. It is totally gone inside that endometrium. So what will we see? There will be so the surface through which it has gone. So this is the what? This is the penetration defect. Penetration defect through which it has gone. So now it has gone. So what will happen? Here you can make a diagram of this. Okay. So this cell is what? We have studied earlier also. This is epiblast. This is the elongated cell. This is the epiblast. Okay. So there's a cavity. This is the amniotic cavity. This is yolk sac cavity. Okay. So now it is the hypoblast. A smaller cell, cuboidal, is your hypoblast. Okay. Okay. And what will happen? So this is the this thing now. The trophoblast. So how will we see this? We will remove this. So trophoblast will be in the. So this is the outer one, is the trophoblast. Okay. So this is the this will be differentiated. This is the amnion cell, and this hypoblast will form a membrane. This is the Russo's membrane. Now trophoblast, we have to focus, since we are studying the placenta, we have to focus about the trophoblast. So trophoblast will be divided into two parts. One is your, this is your, it is divided into this trophoblast. Trophoblast will be divided into cytotrophoblast and syncytiotrophoblast. Okay, so now this is syncytium, multiple nucleated structure. This is syncytiotrophoblast, and other structure around this. This is your cytotrophoblast. Okay, so this is cytotrophoblast. So this all is your cytotrophoblast. Okay, and this is your syncytiotrophoblast. Okay. So what will happen then? What will be the next stage? So this is this mononucleated. This mononucleated is cytotrophoblast, and this multinucleated. This multinucleated with multiple nuclei is your syncytiotrophoblast. Okay, so what will happen after that? There's a lacunar space in between. The space in between. So I could rather make it blue because lacunar system, because you forget this red and this will be blue. Okay, so what will happen? This, there will be extra embryonic cilome formation. These all are outside that embryo, and later on these all fuse to form an extra embryonic cilome. And there is a, what will happen between the cytotrophoblast and trophoblast? This is the oncotrophoblast, this is cytotrophoblast and syncytiotrophoblast. So there is a formation of extra layer of mesoderm. This red one, this is known as, since it is outside the embryo, so it is known as extra embryonic mesoderm between that cytotrophoblast and the outer trophoblastic surface. There is a membrane which is a, since it is a extra embryonic mesoderm. So what will happen? So what is the basic unit of placenta? Placenta has two sides. First, we will keep it here. Then placenta has two sides. It has a fetal side, and it has a maternal side. So as you know, mothers are very tough and form a tough shield to protect their child. So this maternal side is rough and it is attached to the decidua. Decidua, the part is known as decidua basalis. Decidua, so as we know, as the endometrium and after the implantation, it reforms itself and the name nomenclature changes and it will be decidua basalis, parietalis and capsularis. As we discussed in our previous videos, you can see this. And the feature side, which is a soft, as fetus is soft and it is covered with what? Amnion. It is covered with the amnion. So, the placenta has a fetal side and it has a maternal side. So, we will discuss it. So, what will happen? So, this we can, here we can see this. This is the fetal side and maternal side. So, this is fetal side, this is your maternal side, which is attached to the cytotrophoblastic shell. So what is cytotrophoblastic shell? Now we have to do, this is the umbilical region, which is attached to the umbilicus. These are the various septa. This is the maternal side. Ye maternal side hai, so this should be attached to the decidua and it will be attached to the cytotrophoblastic shell. So how this cytotrophoblastic, you must be wondering how this is formed. So cytotrophoblastic cell, so we will come here to this picture. So what will happen later on, this cytotrophoblast is start growing in syncytiotrophoblast. Okay, like this radially, and they will arrange radially also to form a shell or the outer boundary. These all cytotrophoblastic cell. So this is known as, so this is what? This is cytotrophoblast. So this is initially, before the formation of this extra embryonic mesoderm, what will happen? Cytotrophoblast and syncytiotrophoblast. So this is the formation of your primary villi. So this is the primary villi. Villi are what? These are the functional unit of placenta which help in the formation of absorption and exchange of the nutrient, exchange of the oxygen. All those things will be done with the help of the placenta. So this villi, so this cytotrophoblastic cell will grow radially and surrounded by syncytiotrophoblast. We will discuss again. So that is the primary villi, and if it arranges radially around that embryo to form a shell, this is the cytotrophoblastic cell. So this is the area of cytotrophoblastic cell. So as you know, this is the maternal side and this is the fetal side of the placenta. So placenta has the two sides. Septa divides the placenta into various lobes. These septa will divide the placenta into various lobes. So these are the lobes. Now what will happen? There is a trunk. Placenta will be like tree has a trunk. So placenta has a trunk and it has branches. And now so this is space. Now there is a one primary villi. So villi, so this lacunar space, previously the lacunar space in which there is a lacuna formation like this, lacunar space is there. This will be formed what? It will be renamed what? Intervillous space. So it is named as what? Intervillous space. Okay, so what will happen after this cytotrophoblast and syncytiotrophoblast? cytotrophoblast C will be surrounded by S. So this will be your primary villi formation, and these cytotrophoblast cell also radially arounds that embryo to form cytotrophoblastic shell or the cover. Okay. Now these lacunar spaces. These are known as what? Lacunar spaces or the lacuna. Okay. So what will be there? So as this syncytiotrophoblast is eroding into the endometrium, there will be the blood vessel from the maternal side, maternal artery, in the endometrium. So blood is coming through this and filling the lacunar spaces. Okay. So this is the now lacunar spaces or the intervillous spaces, which is filled by the blood, maternal blood. So intervillous spaces. So this is the fetal capillaries in this, and maternal blood is in this. So this is the maternal blood. This is fetal part. Okay. So now this is the trunk like of tree. Then this is small. Give small branches. This also give small branches. Okay. So this is the truncus villi. Means the trunk of the villi, then ramus cori is the first division. This is the first division, this is the ramus, then ramillary. Very small branches. Yes, branching. So all this will be present where? In that intervillous spaces. This is one villi, this is one villi. So all of the intervillous spaces, this space, this will later on, this space after that branching, after the formation of secondary and tertiary villi, this space will be filled by the branching of the villi. And this will help in the establishment of the connection between the fetus and the mother and exchange of the various nutrients organs, various nutrients through the mother to the fetus. So this is the structural unit. Now we will see in detail how that formation of primary villi, secondary villi, tertiary villi will take place, and how this working take place. Okay. So we have seen this, I have drawn this diagram. This is the your cytotrophoblastic shell. Okay. And this is the cytotrophoblast cell, which is giving radially that cell. So now it will be going towards the syncytiotrophoblast. So we will be learning what is the formation, how the formation of various villi. Villi are the projection or mucosal folding. So which help in the absorption? So placenta, in placenta, these are so developed that it's a more than that your intestinal layers or the absorption power is more than this. So this cytotrophoblast is going towards the syncytiotrophoblast. So this is syncytiotrophoblast. So this will be your primary villi. So the spaces, these are the spaces previously known as lacunar spaces. So now between two villi, this is the one villi, these are our primary villi. So how will you remember primary villi? What is primary villi? So this is the primary villi. Primary villi is what? It has a core of C surrounded by S, or cytotrophoblast. This is the cytotrophoblast surrounding by the syncytiotrophoblast, S or C. So how will you remember this? So it's a very easy to remember. Like if you are only one, you don't have any sibling and you are the only one child in your family, then you will be what? You will be center of attraction or of your family. Everyone is loving you only, and you are surrounded by everyone. So you will be their primary attraction. So you will be center of attraction. That means cytotrophoblast surrounded by the syncytiotrophoblast So you will be your primary villa of your house. So that is the primary villa. So you will remember, you will be the center of attraction surrounded by your family members. Then what will happen? This is primary villa. So this is primary villa and the space between them, so this lacunar space previously is now known as intervillous spaces. Intervillous space. Now what will happen? After some years, like 3 or 4 years, your sibling arrived. There is a one sibling. So primary ke baad kya ho jayega? There will be secondary. So secondary is after the arrival of the your sibling. So now sibling comes. Anything, brother or sister. So now the focus of attention. So cytotrophoblast and syncytiotrophoblast. It is there. This is cytotrophoblast and syncytiotrophoblast is there. So what will happen? One extra layer we have seen. So now you are going to becoming what? Extra. You are going to becoming extra. So we will remember extra layer of mesoderm. Okay. So there will be development of extra embryonic mesoderm between that cytotrophoblast or that syncytiotrophoblast, outer layer of cytotrophoblast. So this is the extra embryonic mesoderm. So now there is an entry of something else, your sibling here. So you have become now, this is your C and S, and now the center of attraction, you have become secondary, you have been sifting, so you have become extra. So if extra embryonic mesoderm is present, then this will be your secondary villa. So you have become extra and you have become secondary. So how will you remember? So you have become extra. So by the inclusion of extra embryonic mesoderm, the secondary villa formation takes place. So then again, if the third sibling happens to arrive, to tertiary villi, that is the fetal blood vessel. So now you have become tertiary. Ab koi nahi puchne wala hai. So you have become tertiary of less important, and this is the story of the primary, secondary and tertiary villi. So through the formation of these villi, placenta help or placenta succeed in making connection with the fetal cell, and this part is attached, this is the decidua basalis, decidua part, which is the decidua part, decidua basalis. So this will be shed off after that parturation or the delivery. This part of placenta will be shed off. So this is the primary, secondary and tertiary villi. So how will be the arrangement of the blood capillaries in the placenta? So there will be fetal capillaries and there will be maternal blood, but you have to remember that there is no mixing of blood between the maternal and fetal side. Like this is the primary villi, this is the primary villi, and this is the maternal endometrium. Okay, so here will be your maternal blood. So blood, I will write like this. So this hole is your maternal blood. Okay, so this is your maternal blood. And this is fetal capillaries. So how fetal capillaries will go? So it has an artery. This is your extra embryonic mesoderm. So it has an artery. Arterial system, high pressure system, and it has a venous system. But mind it, this is the extra embryonic mesodermal layer and this is the maternal blood. So here is the maternal blood. This is your maternal blood and in this there is a fetal blood. But mind it, these two are not mixing. This maternal blood and feature bird. They are alone, they are together, but they are not mixing or they are not disturbing each other. So maternal and fetal blood. So what will happen? How then there will be exchange of material? So there will be something which is known as what? Placental barrier. Placental barrier will be there. So through this layer, there will be exchange of the material. So this will be what? Placental barrier. So everything has to cross this barrier to reach the fetus. So that is the placental barrier. So we have this diagram, primary villi. This is the cytotrophoblast cell. And this is the syncytiotrophoblast. SC. I am using the abbreviation. I hope you must be clear till now. This is the extraembryonic mesoderm. And this will be your fetal capillaries. Okay, this will be fetal capillary. So this is F, this is the XE for extraembryonic mesoderm. So now, these are in fetus part, and here will be the maternal part. So for exchange through and through for the fetus and the mother, we need this is the barrier. So what is the layers which is coming in the barrier? So this is layer number 1, 2, 3 and 4. So how will you remember? आपको कैसे याद रखना है? अंदर से बाहर की तरफ क्या क्या layer है in the tertiary villi में अंदर से बाहर की तरफ जो जो layer है, we have to cross that layer and this layer is your placental barrier. So first layer is in red, one is your endothelium lining, endothelium of the fetal capillary. Endothelium of the fetal capillary. Then this red dot is your extra embryonic mesoderm. Okay, easy. Then we have C. Okay, so this will be your cytotrophoblast. And last is your syncytiotrophoblast. So these four layer we have to remember. These form your placental barrier and each and everything which you want to give to the fetus. So before going to the fetus, those molecules or nutrients, everything has to cross that placental barrier to reach the fetus. So we have to be very careful while prescribing any drug to the pregnant women, because many drugs has a teratogenic effect or teratogenic effect. Teratogenic effect means if you give something to the mother and the drug is causing defect or any abnormality in the fetus, those drugs causing effect basically, this should be congenital anomaly or defect in the fetus when given to the mother. This is the teratogenic effect. So we have to be very careful. So any drug which is launched in the market, you have to say it is in category C, D, E, means it is completely safe to give, because if it is not crossing that placental barrier, then it will be safe for the fetus. So it will be safe for the mother also, because it not crossing the barrier, so it will be not affecting the fetus. But if some drug is crossing that placental barrier, then you have to be extra careful while prescribing those drugs to the pregnant female, because then we have to weigh its consequences. Like we have to see, is it really essential or it is a emergency situation or any very important condition? It's really important to give to the mother, then only we have to prescribe the medicine. That is the applied anatomy aspect of this placental barrier. So in this lecture, what we have read about the placenta, how there is structure. So placenta is a disc-like structure. We are recapturing a disc-like structure. It has a maternal side, it has a fetal side. Maternal side is tough, as you know. Mother is very tough, but child is small or soft, so it is covered by the amnion. Then this fetal side and maternal side, then how the formation of primary villi, secondary villi and tertiary villi takes place. So primary villi, so how will you remember? If you are the alone child, you are in the central of attraction. So you will see surrounded by all family members, so that will be your primary villi. Suddenly, after 2 to 3 years, your sibling arrive, you become extra and you become secondary because of the origin of an extra layer. So that is a extra embryonic mesoderm. Then tertiary, if you have a fetal capillaries, then you become tertiary and that will be formation of tertiary villi. And then the part of the fetal side which is attached to the cytotrophoblastic shell, we have read, or the decidua basalis, वहाँ से वो septa जाएगा and it will form the various lobes and loops, and then it will form the fetal cotyledon. What will be the fetal cotyledon? Fetal cotyledon. This will be what? Villus plus its branches. Okay? It is present where? In the intervillous spaces. Intervillous spaces. So from the outside, after the delivery, the external surface, when we see the placenta external surface, it will be divided into various lobes, rough area. Aisa lobes mein 1, 2, 3, 4 lobes divided by grooves or septa. Okay, so placenta will be these decidua basalis and this trophoblastic. So from where it is derived, from their trophoblast and how cytotrophoblastic shell form, all this we have seen. So we have covered that topic, placenta.